السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Imam Nawawi in his 40 hadith mentions a hadith found in the collection of Ibn Majah, which is an authentic hadith narrated by Sahal ibn Sa'd al-Sa'di. The Prophet ﷺ said, a man came to the Prophet ﷺ and he asked, lead me to an action which if I do it, Allah will love me and people will also love me. And the Prophet ﷺ gave him advice and said, be indifferent to worldly things and Allah will love you, and be indifferent to that which people possess and people will love you. This hadith contains some marvelous advice on the subject, which is called in Arabic terminology zuhud, which could be translated as it was here as indifference to the things of this world. Zuhud means that we are not distracted from our goals as Muslims by excessive concerns with worldly matters. But zuhud, when the person who practices zuhud is called zahid, is a person who has priorities in his or her life. The true zahid, or the person who is trying to have this characteristic, has priorities. They understand that our lives as Muslims are journeys. We are on a journey towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so they look to the long-term goals at the end of this journey, which is, of course, to arrive in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, having led a life acceptable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and be rewarded in paradise eternally. And so that is the goal, the journey of every Muslim. And so if we understand that our priority is this journey, then we will not be unduly distracted by things which we find on the way. If I'm on a long trip, I may sometimes pause on my way. I may, for example, need food and drink, and I may stop, and I may stop to buy what I need. I may stop to enjoy myself for a brief time. The Prophet ﷺ gave an example in a hadith found in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, that the way the Prophet ﷺ's life is in this world is like a person who is resting in the shade. They stop during the hottest part of the day, rest in the shade, and then they get up and continue their journey. And that is the way that the Muslim should truly try to have as their attitude in this life. That we can stop and enjoy what is permitted for us in this life. We can have enjoyment. We can sometimes participate in matters in this life, but not excessively so that it distracts us from our ultimate goal. So we should try to spend as much time as possible in Islamic knowledge and worship, and making a conscious effort to observe Islamic behaviors in all aspects of our life. Every Muslim sometimes has to sacrifice things which they love or which they are attracted to. All of us have lusts and desires, things which we want. Sometimes we see that those things which we want are not permitted. And then as Muslims, it is our duty to sacrifice those desires and to give them up. But the level of iman, which the Prophet ﷺ is talking about, is a level beyond that, which is that we are so concerned with our goal as Muslims that we really aren't concerned with those things at all. So we won't feel that it's a sacrifice to give up something. Perhaps somebody newly became a Muslim. Or perhaps they were a sinful Muslim and they were enjoying a life, for example. For example, people enjoy alcohol, or perhaps they enjoyed illicit relationships with the opposite sex. And so when they realized that it's their duty, they gave those things up, perhaps reluctantly. Perhaps they still love those things, but they gave them up for the sake of Allah and they made a sacrifice. And it was difficult for them. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us strong faith, it becomes that we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and love obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much that we don't care about those things anymore. And they become no longer a distraction and something which we are concerned with. So I'm not concerned with too much of those matters anymore. But I'm concentrated on my goal. This does not mean that we do not have any worldly ambitions as Muslims. This does not mean that, for example, I can't try to be successful in my education and career and Perhaps I'm in a business, perhaps I'm in a job in which I'm rewarded for my hard work with good pay. This does not mean that in this case I am concentrating on the world. As a Muslim who's practicing zuhud, my ultimate goal is the pleasure of Allah. And so I have found worldly goals which are permitted to me in Islam. I've strived to help myself, to maintain myself, to become independent of needing other human beings to support me, and also able to support my family, to help my relatives, neighbors, and needy Muslims by my wealth. So as a concerned Muslim who is not overly concerned and distracted with the life of this world, I look at my career and my goals in, for example, money and wealth and possessions as a means to pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a means of purifying myself, devoting myself to worship. So for example, if I become a wealthy man, I see that I can give in charity, I can build mosques, I could build perhaps hospitals, I could help many people throughout the world. I could help spread Islam. I could use my money and donate it, for example, to the spread of Islam, for example, by the new technology of satellite television, for example, or other things that I could do for the sake of Allah. And so in this case, my using my time to make money is a good thing, and it's part of my ibadah or worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not distracting me from my goal of serving my Creator, but actually it's helping me. And even if I'm a common person, and I really have no ambition to become wealthy, but at least I don't want to be a person who has to go and beg for help from others. I don't want to bother people and be a burden on them, because that's going to bring a difficulty in our brotherhood and relationship. But by being able to support myself, and making enough money to take care of myself, and do my duty toward my family, and support them, then I can feel good about myself, and I can also spend my time in worship and thankfulness, gratitude for the good things which I have received from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes we have ambitions in this life. We have goals. We want to achieve worldly things, money and position and other permitted goals in Islam. But sometimes we try hard and do not succeed. Sometimes we fail to get to the highest level. Maybe in my education, I tried my best and didn't quite make it to the highest level. Or maybe in my career, even though I've worked very hard, there are other people who advance farther and faster than me. But having the attitude of zuhud means that all I'm concerned about is that I have done my best in halal activities, and I'm trying to serve my Creator, and that is my ultimate goal. So if I fail, knowing that I have done my best, I'm satisfied and I accept that from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even if I have trials and tribulations, poverty, bad health, and things which happen to me, I will accept that, and that does not make me give up. It doesn't make me give up hope. It doesn't make me give up striving and trying to better myself Islamically, and also to work for those goals that I have in my career or business or education or other permitted Islamic goals.